Hello, my name is Ranger Jeremy Hulse, and I'd like to welcome you to Cunningham Falls State Park. The late winter and early spring is maple sugaring time out here. This is an annual tradition dating back many years. Maple sap is mostly water. It takes about 40 gallons to yield 1 gallon of pure maple syrup. There are a few different methods for processing. We'll concentrate on the batch method, commonly used by colonists, early maple syrup producers, and modern-day small batch efforts like ours. Here at the park, we use a 22-gallon cast iron kettle on a metal stand with a wood-fueled fire underneath. We fill our vessel almost to the top, then get our fire going to bring the sap to a heavy, continuous boil. A batch this size will take between 4 and 6 hours, so it's important that we keep plenty of dry wood on hand. We'll periodically use a metal skimmer to remove any foam, debris, or other impurities from the sap. This will also help to reduce the chances of it scorching. There are three main methods that you can use to determine when the evaporation process is finished: temperature, sugar content, and viscosity. Tree sap is mostly water, which boils at 212 degrees Fahrenheit. But as water evaporates, the sugar content rises. So does its boiling temperature. When the thermometer reaches 219 degrees, we've hit our mark. It's time to remove our cooking vessel from the heat source, because if it gets any hotter, our syrup will scorch. Another indicator is sugar content and density, and for that, we would use a hydrometer. It should have a hot syrup line and a cold syrup line, because the temperature of the sap or syrup will affect the reading. To take a measurement, we carefully fill a specialized test cup with hot syrup until it is between 1 and 2 inches from the top. Then place a cup on the level surface. Then, slowly lower the hydrometer into that test cup until it is floating on the syrup or gently resting on the bottom. At the same time, insert a thermometer into that test cup as well. At roughly 211 degrees Fahrenheit, your hydrometer should float at or close to the hot syrup line, indicating the correct density and sugar content, about 66%. A more simple method, and our favorite to use, is to check the viscosity of the syrup. We would scoop up a ladleful and quickly pour it back into the kettle. Then hold the now empty ladle upside down into the cool air. If the syrup drips down like water, it needs more time. If things are just right, we would see a caramel-colored ring of syrup hanging from the rim. It's called the crystalline curtain. Once the evaporation process is complete, we pour the hot syrup through a metal strainer lined with cheesecloth and let it drip into a food-safe container. Then, while it's still hot, we transfer the syrup into sterile mason jars, close them with a fresh lid and ring, and place them upside down on a flat surface and leave them undisturbed until you hear them pop. Once jarred, syrup can last up to 2 years at room temperature, and it can last up to 10 years or more if refrigerated. Thanks again for joining us. If you love maple syrup as much as we do, make a plan to attend our annual Maple Syrup Festival, where you can find tons of information, active demonstrations, and a whole lot more. Call the park office or go to cunninghamgambrel.org for details and dates.